Okay. Good morning, children. Yes. Here we are going to discuss about 16 unit of 9th class mathematics. Linear equations in two variables. In the earlier classes, we have known that in 7th and 8th, basic concepts have been learnt. What are angles? Next, what is the ray? Next, properties of parallel lines and different aspects, different what is it? Concepts have been learned which are depending upon equations in two variables, linear equations. Now, I want to recall some more examples which we have learned in 7th and 8th. That are very simple to understand that now I want to take a plane P. You know, a plane is a plane. To assume that this is a plane P, now naming as P. A plane P, take it, and now I am going to draw a horizontal line. When I draw a horizontal line, the plane has been divided into two parts, maybe equal parts or may not be, but whereas two parts are divided, as we draw a horizontal line. Next, in the same way, if I draw one more line, that is vertically, vertical line, if I draw horizontal and vertical line, the plane has been divided into four parts. Each part is called as a quadrant. Quadrant. How many quadrants have been found now? There are four quadrants. This we call as a Q1. And it is Q2, and we say this is Q3, and it is Q4. Q means quadrant, quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and quadrant 4. So why do we draw a two axis? It is called a horizontal line, namely x axis, and this is a vertical line called as a y axis. Now I make some units on them by taking the integers. Each unit has been taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7. Each unit must be equal either both sides. It is very easy to understand that where do they intersect? X axis and y axis are intersected at one point that is taken as a O, called as origin. Now the scale is observed as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here left side -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7. But what about at 0, at origin? We know that integers leads here 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and left side becomes 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. As we see that the difference is one unit from here to here and here to here and here to here. Same as now I am going to take some more units like on y-axis. Very simple, very easy. Now actually we have a graph of right side before our board. Now we take this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, and -8. Here we took 1, 0, that is on x-axis. In the same way, on y-axis will be one more 0. It becomes this 0 is called as a y-coordinate. This is called x-coordinate, not quadrant coordinate. Coordinates. So what coordinates means? Coordinate means a point which is located on the graph, which is located on the plane. Here origin O is located on the graph where x-axis and y-axis are intersected at O. Its point is taken as 0, 0. 0, 0 is a point. Its location is at a intersecting point of two lines, that is a horizontal line and a vertical line. Very simple. Now I want to say in Telugu, very easy to understand. Manam em chesnam, oka talam isnam, P ane talam isnam, aa talani x aksham ani ante bhoomiki క్షితి సమాంతరంగా ఉండేటట్టుగా అడ్డుగా ఒక రేఖ గీసినాం, నిలువు ఒక రేఖ గీసినాం. ఈ రెండు రేఖలు గీయడం వల్ల ఆ తలము ప్లేన్ అనేది నాలుగు భాగాలు విడిపోయింది. ఈ భాగాలే మనం తెలుగులు ఏమంటామంటే పాదాలు అంటాం. మొదటి పాదం, రెండవ పాదం, మూడవ పాదం, నాలుగవ పాదం. ఎస్, క్వాడ్రంట్ 1, క్వాడ్రంట్ 2, క్వాడ్రంట్ 3, క్వాడ్రంట్ 4. ఎప్పుడైతే x అక్షం, y అక్షము ఒక బిందువు దగ్గర ఖండించుకుందో, ఆ బిందువు యొక్క నిరూపకాలు కోఆర్డినేట్స్. నిరూపకాలు ఏమైంది అంటే మనకు తెలుసు ఇక్కడ ఎక్స్ అక్షం మీద 0 ఉంది, వై అక్షం మీద కూడా 0 తీసుకున్నాం. కాబట్టి ఇది ఎక్స్ అక్షము 0, ఆ ఎక్స్ కోఆర్డినేట్ అంటే ఎక్స్ నిరూపకం 0, వై నిరూపకం 0. ఇక్కడ ఏమంటాం, ఆరిజిన్, ఆరిజిన్ ఓ 0, 0. This is called one more words, abscissa and ordinate. Abscissa and ordinate. Abscissa. This is called ordinate. Abscissa, ordinate. X coordinate, Y coordinate. There are two ways to say their names. X coordinate called as abscissa, Y coordinate is called as ordinate. Okay, very simple to remember. Now I am going to here what did you observe here? Mudati padamu, rendava padamu, moodava padamu, naalugava padamu baagundi. Mari enti padamula vishayam enti nenu okasari chustunna. Ikkada nunchi nenu ikkada oka there I want to take a point A. A and A point is 9. Ekkadali? In the first quadrant. First quadrant lo oka point A is 9. E point A yokka location enti? Then what is the name of A? A is the name of the point, but what its coordinates? Coordinates means, now we know that the first one is which were closed in the bracket. The first one is called x coordinate and the second one is y coordinate. So as that, now we have to write the first quadrant, x coordinate is 3, and the same way to the left and y axis. See straightly where it is located, it is 5. Now the point A is 3, 5. Point A is called 3, 5. Now I want to take here 1. B, point B. Point B coordinates are -5, 1. See how we should see straightly into the y-axis. Here it is associated 1. Here it is associated -5. So that B point is -5, 1. The name of the point is B, its coordinates are -5, 1. So very simple to say that on x-axis, the right side are all positive indicators and y also positive indicators, so that positive and positive, see plus 3 and plus 5, same as here. Now minus 5 and plus 1, so that minus comma plus, next here it is, x minus is there, y minus is there. And fourth quadrant, each quadrant how? Positive and negative. Positive and negative. Very simple to say that what are the sign of the coordinates in Q1, in Q2, in Q3 and Q4. Very easy to say that in Q1 both the coordinates are positive, in Q2 x is negative and y is positive, in Q3 means third quadrant, both are negative, and whereas in fourth quadrant x is positive and y is negative. So this is a location of the points we have understood. How do we locate? Here we have our original graph before us. Now I want to draw on them. Next, very easy to understand. If we did not have a graph, it is easy to draw like. Next, one more thing. Just I introduced what is a plane and how it is divided and what are the coordinates. In each quadrant, what point of points means coordinates, negative, positives. So after that, now I am going to introduce what is a linear equation. What is the line? You know, line L. It is the physical appearance of the line L. There are two ways. Actually, there are so many closest friends to me. Now I say Ramesh, Sridhu sir, and Ramu sir, but before us they are not there. But their names I read like that. Here physically the line is there, but what its name? L is given. Symbolically means algebraically, how do we say? Very simple. Now come to graph. I would like to say one line. Now I am going to write one more. This is y axis, no? This is x axis, you know. X axis and y axis. What is said now? For every line, there is algebraically names. Yes, don't we have a name of x-axis algebraically? Yes, we have. That is y is equal to 0. The name of x-axis is called y equal to 0. And name of y-axis is x equal to 0. So what sir? Taking x-axis, but its name algebraically is y equal to 0. Why is to say that y equal to 0? The line x-axis is on line x-axis. Everywhere in at minus 1, at minus 2, at minus 3, at minus 4, at minus 5, at minus 6, at minus 7. We do not going up and down on the x-axis exactly. Here also, if we go here, what y means? Y means if y go up, y positive. If you go down, y negative. On the x-axis means y 0, no? This is. So that the line of x-axis name algebraically y equal to 0. So that in the same way, the name of y-axis, the name of y-axis algebraically, that is x equal to 0. Now we see them, it is physically line. It is physically line, but their names are x equal to 0 y axis, y equal to 0 x axis. Same as this, now I am going to draw one more line that is, see other very clearly what I am going to draw here, just in the right, okay. A line is drawn, where it is located, how it passes, means it is passed through three and parallel to y-axis. Very simple, parallel to y-axis. This is called x equal to 0, why? Because y quadrant is 0, x quadrant is 0, x quadrant is 0, so that x equal to 0. Here x quadrant is 3, so that this name is x equal to 3. Same as that, now I am going to draw one more line here. It is called what? X equal to 5. It is called x equal to minus 2. Yes, what have we learned from these three examples? A line has its own name. From where does it pass? From where it passes? It is passing through minus 2, so that x equal to minus 2 is a line. Now I am going to draw this one more. X equal to what? Minus 6. Not only for this, yes, now I am going to draw one more line, that is from x equal to minus 7. What happens? Y equal to, y equal to, what is this? Minus 7. Why it is taken as minus 7? This is y equal to 0, no? Same as that, to this line, to this x-axis, a line is parallelly drawn through minus 7. So that y equal to minus 7, this is. So here, now I am going to draw one more line through here. It is y equal to minus 2. Y equal to minus 2. Very simple. Very simple to understand. Yes. Here, linear equations in two variables. But I took only one variable in every line. Here a line is drawn, its name is y equal to minus 7. Here a line is drawn, it is x equal to minus 6. Here a line is drawn, x equal to minus 2. Here a line is drawn, x equal to 3. Here a line is drawn, x equal to 5. Here a line is drawn, y equal to minus, plus 2, sorry. Plus 2, no? Yes. Next. We can take their own names like L, M, N, O, P, Q, like that. But algebraically their names are like y equal to minus 7. Algebraically its name is x equal to minus 6. There are so many girls, there are so many boys, there are so many men, there are so many women, but they have their own name. I am a man. Man, not woman. Man, but I have a own name, that is Venkana. It's like that. The straight line has its own name, that is x equal to minus 6. It is located how? By observing the where it does it passing. Where it passes. Ekkada nunchi pothundo akkada patte manam daniki a peru pettunam. Next. Very simple. Here I want to know one more thing. Linear equation in one variable we discussed now. Linear equations in one variable discussed. For example, here it is 2x plus 3 equal to 5. Is it a linear equation or not? Yes. How? Now I am going to transpose this 3 to right side. What happens? 2x is equal to 5 minus 3. 2x equal to 5 minus 3 means 2. Now going to transpose this, it's a coefficient now, becomes what? 2 by 2, 2 to get cancelled, x equal to 1, Yes, x equal to 1 means where passes up. Like here it goes like x equal to 1. See, very simple to say that the given equation is like 2x plus 3 is equal to 5, but we have located, we have drawn a linear, what is the line on the graph. Did you understand clearly? Okay. Very simple to say that 2x plus 3 is equal to 5. Next. Now I wrote here one example that 2x plus 3 is equal to 5. Here one thing I want to say, whenever it is simplified by taking x equal to 1, x equal to 1 we got and drawn on graph. Now I want to put x equal to 1. What we got? 1 we got. Now I am going to substitute here. X means where x is here. In this place we put in 1. 2 of 1 plus 3 equal to 5. 2 1 2 plus 3 equal to 5. 2 plus 3 equal to 5 equal to 5. Yes, the line, the linear equation where for x the value is satisfying the equation, this is called the solution of the equation. What a solution of the equation. X equal to 1, by solving we got x equal to 1 and drawn on graph. But whether it is satisfying the equation or not, that I am going to substitute x means 1, 2 of 1 plus 3 equal to 5. 2 1 the 2 plus 3 equal to 5. Where LHS is 5 and RHS is 5. LHS means left hand side to the equal symbol, and right hand side means right hand side of the equal symbol. Or both are equal, so that 1 is for the solution of this equation. Here I want to say one thing, that is a linear equation which has one variable has only one solution, unique solution. What a unique. Unique solution. No other solution is to be satisfied in any equation. See how now I want to say one equation, that is very simple to understand that it is x equal to 5, you know, x equal to 5. Very simple. Yes, a line that is x equal to 5. X equal to 5. What is the solution of this line? 5. Here x equal to 1 taken, 1 is the solution. Okay, over. Now what I want to say that here if we see this, here is 5 going upward up to 1 becomes 5 comma 1. Now I am going to up like that 5 comma 2. See what is going to write. Next, here it is 3. Now the point of 5 comma 3 here. 5 comma 3. Next, 5 comma 4. Next, like that here it will be 5 comma 8. Here it will be 5 comma 9. Very simple. You might have some doubt, that is why don't we have a solution that is 5 comma 1 and 5 comma 2, 5 comma 3, 5 comma 4 and 5 comma 9. Or these are not solutions. Yes. Why? Because a line has an infinite set of points. Actually, this is a whiteboard. Now I draw a line, that is by adding a point, point, one point, 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 getting a line. So that how many points meeting a line? There are an infinite set of points to make a line. So that Here it is 5 comma 1 is a point, 5 comma 2 is a point, 5 comma 3 is a point, 5 comma 4 is a point. Between them there are some or 5 comma 3.1, 5 comma 3.2, 5 comma 3.9, 5 comma 3.9 after 5 comma 4 become. So what it is easy to understand that a line has a number of points on it. Number of infinite number of points lie on the same line. But what the solution means? The common solution is 5, 5, 5. So that x is equal to 5 is only the unique solution. What is that? Unique solution. If we take x equal to 5, what we put to equalize the, to satisfy the equation? If we put x equal to 1, what becomes? 1 is equal to 5, no, not. If we put x equal to 2, 2 is equal to 5, no, not. If we put x equal to 3, 3 equal to 5, no, not at all. So that when we get equalized, when we get satisfied x equal to 5, yes, when we put 5 is equal to 5. Right side is already there, that is constant. But now we are putting the values for variable. Yes, if we put x equal to 5, yes, the equation is satisfying the condition equal simple. So that 5 is only the solution, that is called as a unique solution. Okay, easy to understand clearly, very nice. Okay, are you getting? Now I am going to what the two variables, what happened, why? See, in this graph, really, I drawn only the lines which are parallel to y-axis and some more drawn parallel to x-axis, but not drawn like. నేను ఈ విధంగా డ్రా చేయలే అలా డ్రా చేసి ఎలా ఉంటాయంటే ఇవి ఉంటాయి ద లైన్ విచ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ప్యారలల్ టు ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ అండ్ నాట్ ప్యారలల్ టు వై యాక్సిస్ విల్ బి ఇన్ టూ వేరియబుల్స్ నాట్ లైక్ దట్ సి హౌ సమ్ టైమ్స్ విల్ గో లైక్ హావ్ సమ్ స్లాంట్ హౌ దే ఆర్ పాసింగ్ on quadrants, it has some slope, it has some slant height, so that it must have two variables. For example, I want to say, what is that? Okay, now I am going to say here, how two variables have been taken to form a linear equation. Yes, here I wrote two examples here. How do we make them as a linear equations in two variables? Very simple to say that. Listen me, one example what you say. You say, Indra's father, Indra yokka tandri, bought two pencils, konnadu rendu pencils ni, and 5 notebooks for her. ఆమె కోసం ఎవరి కోసం ఇద్దరి కోసం వాళ్ళ నాన్న రెండు పెన్సిల్స్ని 5 నోట్బుక్స్ని కొన్నాడు. ఈ పెయిడ్ 110 rupees ఫర్ పర్చేజింగ్ కొన్నందుకు ఆయన 110 rupees ఎవరికి ఇచ్చాడు? షాప్ కీపర్కి ఇచ్చాడు. ఎస్ హౌ డు వి రైట్ లిజన్ మీ హియర్ వెరీ ఈజీ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఇన్ వాట్ వే వీ హావ్ టు థింక్ ఏ రూట్లో మనం దీన్ని అర్థం చేసుకోవాలి. ఇందిరాస్ ఫాదర్ బాట్ టూ పెన్సిల్స్ రెండు పెన్సిల్స్ కొన్నాడు 5 నోట్బుక్స్ కొన్నాడు బట్ వీ డోంట్ నో వాట్ ఇస్ ద కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎ పెన్సిల్ అండ్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎ నోట్బుక్ ఒక నోట్బుక్ ధర తెలియదు ఒక పెన్సిల్ ధర తెలియదు బట్ హీ బాట్ టూ పెన్సిల్స్ అండ్ 5 నోట్బుక్స్ బట్ పెయిడ్ టోటల్లీ 110 హియర్ ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఏ స్టూడెంట్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ 9th క్లాస్ బాట్ మన 9వ తరగతి పిల్లలు ఒకళ్ళు పెన్సిల్స్ కొన్నారు 3 rupees చొప్పున ఒక్కొక్క పెన్సిల్ 3 rupees చొప్పున కొన్నారు కానీ ఎన్ని పెన్సిల్ కొన్నా మన దగ్గర అండ్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ ఈచ్ ఈజ్ 15 rupees ఒక్కొక్క పుస్తకానికి 15 rupees టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ని కొన్నారు మొత్తం ఏంటి ఏం చేసిండు షాప్ కీపర్ కి 150 రూపాయలు చెల్లించిండు
yes what is the difference between these two examples very simple to say that here we don't know how many number of pencils bought here we don't know here what is the cost of pencil we don't know here cost of pencil not there and the cost of notebook is not there here cost of pencil is there but how many pencils number of pencils not there and textbooks books also not there how many textbooks are bought nenu em antunna edaithe ledo evaithe ivvaledo vaatni em antunnanante yes there are two things one is pencil and another one is notebook what is not there cost of pencil is not there now I write that let solution let the cost of pencil be ₹3 x let the cost of notebook b rupees y na telavu ikkada enta chudandi udaharanaki ikkada 2 rupayalu anukundam oka pencil ki appudu rendu pencil ku 2 2 4 ante 2 multiply chesthe pencil cost telisipothundi ikkada y em anukunnanu cost of notebook ki di 10 rupayalu anukundam oka notebook ki enko enta 5 notebooks ante 5 × 10 = 15 okay very simple to understand there we have a linear equation that is 2x plus 5y equal to 110 same as this how do we write a linear equation in both the variables a student of our 9th class bought pencils for rupees 3 here what to let them em anukovali manam ikkada x ani yes cost is given so number of pencils how many number of pencils bought not there so that how I write let number of pencils be x and let the number of hours what is it notebooks be y yes అవును x సంఖ్యలో నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పెన్సిల్స్ ఆర్ x x ఇంటూ 3 ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇక్కడ 3 కొన్నాడు అనుకోండి 3 పెన్సిల్స్ ఒక్కొక్క 3 రూపాయలు అంటే 9 రూపాయలు అట్లాగే ఇక్కడ కూడా 15 ఉన్నాయి అనుకో ఒక్కొక్క దానికి 10 రూపాయలు అయితే 15 రూపాయలు 150 అంటే నేను ఇక్కడ సమ్ చేయాలి నేను ఇక్కడ తీసుకోవాల్సింది ఏంటంటే ఎంతో మనం తెలుసుకోవాలి పోయి అందుకోసం నేను ఏమంటున్నాను ఎస్ హౌ టు ఐ రైట్ దట్ 3 ఇంటూ x plus 15 into y equals to 150 how do we apply to our livelihood in our livelihood situations a linear equation chapter how it is related to our livelihood mana jeevita vidhanalo ee rendu ఎట్లా తీసుకోవాలనేది ఒకసారి చూస్తే చూడండి ఏదైతే మనం తీసుకోవాలనుకున్నామో అక్కడ చూడండి ఇక్కడ 2 ఉంది ఇక్కడ 5 ఉంది ఇక్కడ 110 ఉంది వాట్ టు వేర్స్ అబ్జర్వింగ్ దెమ్ దేర్ ఆర్ రియల్ నెంబర్స్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పెన్సిల్స్ అండ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ నోట్బుక్స్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి నెగటివ్ సో దట్ అండ్ ది కాస్ట్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి నెగటివ్ so that real numbers and positive integers and now I would like to take as a and b and c here a and b and c the general form of linear equations in two variables is the general form of, how do we write the, what we discuss of here, the general form of, general form of a linear equation, linear equation in two variables, is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. If we transpose 110 to left side, it becomes 2x plus 5y minus 110 equal to 0. So here c value becomes minus 110. Here it becomes minus 150. As we get the equation into this form, ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Yes. Remember it. Read it. Read it twice or thrice when our class is going to be run. మనం క్లాస్ రన్ అయినప్పుడే దాన్ని మూడు సార్లు వెళ్ళవేయాలి. ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ డివై ప్లస్ సి ఈక్వల్ జీరో, ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ డివై ప్లస్ సి ఈక్వల్ జీరో, ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ డివై ప్లస్ సి ఈక్వల్ జీరో. ఎస్, ఇంటిపోయిన తర్వాత సాయంత్రానికి ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ డివై ప్లస్ సి ఈక్వల్ జీరో అది రావాలి. దట్ ఈస్ ద వే ఆఫ్ లెర్నింగ్ వే ఆఫ్ రిమెంబరింగ్ ఎ ఫార్ములా ఆర్ ఎ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆర్ ఎన్ ఈక్వేషన్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ద టర్మ్స్ ఆర్ వీఆర్ attaining in our subject. Okay, ax plus dy plus c equal to 0 is a general form of a straight line. Okay, shall we close for today class? Okay, let us close tomorrow. Some more examples on this chapter and linear equations in two variables. Okay, right.